Welcome back to Exotic Car Play Place, everyone. Thanks for joining in again this beautiful Friday morning. And today we are going to share with you 10 of the best luxury and performance cars under $10,000. Maybe you don't have a ton of money, but you don't need it. You can actually find some really great buys under 10 grand that you can enjoy for many, many more years to come. Let's get into it now. Welcome back to the channel, everybody. Mark with Exotic Car Play Place. So my first recommendation for top performance and luxury cars under 10 grand goes to the early Porsche Boxster. That's right, these cars shared interiors with the 911, similar flat six engine configuration as the 911s of the era. They shared the same headlights and many other components, which often were easily mistaken with the 911. The beauty is you didn't have to spend the 911 dollars. As well, because these were mid-engine, they handled better than its big brother, the 911. Now, these cars came with a 201 horsepower, 2.5 liter flat six engine that were coupled to either a five speed manual gearbox, or you could actually get an automatic. Now, there were a couple of traps with these cars. Buyer beware. The rear window on the soft top was susceptible to cracking because it was plastic. As well, these cars were susceptible to what they called the intermediate shaft bearing related issues, whereas the bearings, the ball bearings themselves, could come apart. If they did, it meant a catastrophic engine failure. This was a serious issue. However, due to the price of these cars, you can still get yourself a great car. If you're lucky enough, you can find a car that's been properly serviced, maybe a new clutch and the upgraded IMS bearing, and you can get yourself a great modern day Porsche that can outhandle its big brother 911. You can enjoy it for many, many years to come. So the second recommendation to you for great luxury cars or sports cars under 10 grand goes to the wonderful, venerable, unforgettable E39 540i BMW. That's right, these cars feature the M62 4.4 liter naturally aspirated V8. They featured about 282 horsepower and up to 325 pound-feet of torque, which made them a real torque monster, great for smoky smoke shows. And it was dramatically less money than the M5 of the same generation, which, quite frankly, the prices have gone so high that it's almost impossible to get one for a reasonable dollar. Now, these cars you can get with a manual or automatic transmission. They were fairly dependable, and actually these cars were great because they came out just before the Chris Bangle or the Bangle Butt 5 Series cars. And for that reason, they were highly sought after and loved. Now, you have many choices from a 1995 all the way up to 2003, and they're all relatively the same. 0 to 60 miles per hour in around 5 seconds flat. Made them very quick, very fun, and very affordable for a 5 Series BMW. Highly recommended. Love that 540 E39. But seriously, folks, what kind of list would this be if I didn't include the infamous or famous E60 M5? That is BMW's F1-derived V10 5-liter engine that produced over 500 horsepower. Now, these cars could do 0 to 60 in about 4.1 seconds if properly equipped. They came with a 7-speed automated manual gearbox called the SMG, or you could get with a 6-speed manual. But the real party trick came with the fact that these cars, when ungoverned, could hit 204 miles per hour, and as well had one of the sexiest soundtracks anywhere of any car. Only downfall is, you better understand, the rod bearings are good for 100,000 kilometers. The SMG system had problems, Vano system had occasional glitches, and the rear electronic differential had issues as well from time to time. Get around those things and you can truly own one of the best super saloon cars for under 10 grand. If you shop hard and fast, you can find a great one. Pick one up now, because there's only one place for these cars' values to go, and that's up through the roof once people figure out how great these cars really are. So my fourth recommendation goes to a Mercedes-Benz this time. How about an E320 wagon? For those people that like the versatility of a wagon or a touring vehicle, but they also like the luxury of the Mercedes, this really does cover the entire gambit. Now, this comes from an era in the late 90s and early 2000s when Mercedes-Benz did still provide a relatively analog driving experience, way before all this modern electronics took over. This car truly is man versus machine, and really does have a lot of the typical classical Mercedes styling elements. Great cars, relatively sturdy and reliable. The only thing you got to watch out for is some of these vintages had rust and corrosion related issues. If you're buying a car from down south, you should be fine. If you're buying something from in the northern states or Canada, or of course Eastern Europe, be sure to make sure that you do a proper inspection that you have a solid car that's not full of rot in behind. Other than that, great cars. Fifth choice goes to a 3 Series BMW, and that is specifically the E46 BMW. That's right, you had 320s, you had 325s, 330s. You could even possibly, on occasion, find an M3 for around 10 grand. Lots of great selections from sedans to coupes to even touring vehicles. Lots of options, manuals, automatics, and a whole gamut of different horsepower and outputs. In certain markets, you could even get a diesel. Now, these were great cars, and they bridged the gap nicely between the E36, which was starting to look a little bit dated, and of course, the E90 series, which now coincidentally seemed to be plagued with a lot of plastic-related issues. Coolant problems, oil leaks from plastic valve covers, oil pan gaskets, lots of issues with leaks in the E90 series. So if you really want to get one of those classic BMWs that's still very analog, very driver oriented, and relatively reliable, let's not forget the E46, one of the highly recommended BMWs of the era. So my sixth selection of recommended luxury cars that are so undervalued and underappreciated, that itself makes it such a great buy. 2002 to 2005 Mercedes-Benz CLK 320s. These cars produced 215 horsepower, was more than enough to move this car briskly down the road, had the classic Mercedes styling with those wonderful front end, not too unlike the E-Class that we just spoke of on the touring car, but they had your classic Mercedes sturdily built interiors, the wonderful exteriors, and honestly were just such a great value. Again, similar to the E320 though, I would recommend that you pay close attention to corrosion related issues because these cars as well were susceptible to rotting out if they were exposed to too much salty roads. So my seventh recommended luxury car that maybe is actually a little more performance oriented is the B5 S4 Audi. These cars came equipped with a twin turbo V6 engine of 2.7 liters displacement. They had the infamous quattro all-wheel drive system, had the wonderful, magnificent fit and finish that you would expect from an Audi, plus a very roomy and spacious interior, high quality finishing, and you could also get it with a 6-speed manual gearbox. This car absolutely represented everything from performance, luxury that you could possibly hope for in a German luxury vehicle. Of course, all this luxury goodness comes with a caveat with this particular car, in that the turbochargers, if they failed, and they often did because they weren't the most robust, it meant a lot of equipment had to come out to get access to them, and it was quite an extensive labor job to replace turbos. As well as the interior had its faults too, with glitchy dashboard electronics, which often failed or went blank on you. So it had its glitches and gremlins, but from a driving perspective, they were really hard to beat, and the quality and fit and finish were really second to none. So my eighth recommendation for luxury vehicles goes to the BMW X5. Now, these start back in 2000. They represented some great luxury SUV motoring. They had lots of room. They really dominated the marketplace. You could also get a variety of motors from V8s to inline sixes. So they had different drivetrains to suit your needs. Then as you moved into later generations, for example, the E70, you could also get a turbo diesel engines, and you could even get M models. Now, many of these models now have come down to the price where you can tackle a lot of these for under 10 grand. They represent just a phenomenal, outstanding value. Large vehicles, lots of power, extreme luxury, and quite honestly, for the most part, very reliable. The M models, not as much, but stay with the mainstream, and many of these cars can suit you for many years to come. So my ninth choice goes to the Porsche 944. Have you heard of that one? Yes, in fact, it is a lot better than a lot of people give it credit for as well. Now, in the mid-80s, these cars came out. They had a basic four-cylinder engine and a relatively modest interior, more or less derived from the earlier Volkswagen-based 924 Porsches. But as the 944 evolved, it gave you great suspension, it gave you powerful engines with nice flares, it gave you sunroofs, leather interiors, and quite honestly, a lot of feature for the money in its day. If you saved up a few more bucks, you could either move into the 85 and a half model year, where they revised the exterior, gave you better bumpers, and a much cleaner leather interior. As well, if you hold on and pushed a little further, 1986 represented the turbo, which had about 220 horsepower and could launch that car from 0 to 60 in about 6.1 seconds, represented blistering performance. It could also whop out 165 miles per hour in the later versions of the turbo. Great buy, awesome bang for your buck, and honestly was still one of the best balanced Porsches of all time. Highly sought after in some circles, and honestly, just a phenomenal car all the way around. So, what would this list be without a Lexus? In fact, Lexus are known for their reliability, so naturally it seems fitting that we should have one car on this list at least that tops the reliability sector, and that is a 2007 Lexus IS 350. That really is the best blend between reliability and performance. This car, in fact, had a 3.5-liter V6 engine that produced about 306 horsepower and about 277 pound-feet of torque. It could launch this car from 0 to 60 mile per hour in about 5.6 seconds. Did you also know it could go from 80 to 120 kilometers an hour in as little as 4.5 seconds. Now, these cars had dual cam and they had variable valve timing on both camshafts. The electric steering was actually also dialed in a lot better than some of the electric steering in modern BMWs. It actually gave you a relatively direct feel. And of course, it had lots of great features for its day. Tilt and telescopic steering, sunroof, leather interior, rain sensing wipers, a very elaborate 10-way power seats for both passenger and the driver, backup camera, and bi-xenon headlights. The only down point to these cars was they had a 6-speed manumatic automatic transmission, which when you put it into manual mode and you toggle the shifter over to the manual mode, it automatically went from what could be 6th gear if you're on the highway, kick right down to 4th immediately, which was very jarring and of course could be hard on the transmission and of course possibly could lead to premature failure. Outside of that, know that little nuance and you could enjoy yourself a high-performing, well-handling, well-equipped modern-day Lexus vehicle. And again, guaranteed, reassured, it will be chock full of reliability. Thanks again for sticking around to the end, guys. Hey, click on the link over here. You're going to love that great video on some of the worst luxury car disasters of 2020 as well. Don't forget to subscribe to the channel right over here as well as hit that notifications bell because it'll let you know when the next great video arrives. Hope to see you guys real soon. Catch you then. Bye-bye.